Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're looking at how to find the total area of a square pyramid. And a square pyramid has a point, an apex at the top, and the base is a square. So let's look at one. Okay, so here is our square pyramid, and the base is 10 on each side. And then we have a height on the inside, and then we have what we call a slant height, which is from the apex of the point all the way down to the side of the base, in the middle of the base. Now that distance right here is what we're going to need to find surface area. Okay, so our formula works like this. We have to have kind of two parts to our formula. The first part is the lateral area. Well, the lateral area are these triangles on the outside that go around the triangle. So if you take this and you fold it out, you can see that this lateral area is just four triangles. So to find the area of four triangles, you could find the area of one triangle and then just multiply it by four and you would have the lateral area. But there's a little easier formula for that. For the lateral area, we're going to use the formula 1/2 base times height. But instead of being the base just being one triangle, we're going to do the base of all four. So that actually is the perimeter of the base. And then we're going to multiply it times the height. Well, the height in this case is our slant height. So it's 1/2 perimeter times slant height. So let's find the perimeter first. Well, the perimeter of the base, and that is the perimeter of the base, is 10 on each side. So 10 times all four sides is 40. So we have 1/2 of 40 times our slant height. Well, in this case, our slant height is given to us as 9.01. We're just going to round it off to 9 for a good measure. So we're going to take that times 9. So now we have 1/2 times 40 times 9. So that's 1/2 of 40 is 20. And 20 times 9 is 180. And this would be in square units, whether it's inches or feet, it's an area. So that gives us the lateral area of our pyramid. Now we haven't, that accounts for all four of the triangles. Now we need to account for the square. Well, square is easy. So the base area of this pyramid is just side squared, because the base is a square. Well, the side of this base up here is given as 10. So 10 squared is 100. So how many bases do I have? Well, on a pyramid, I only have one base. So I'm going to add 100 to 180, and that's going to give us 280 square units. So this last part is to take my lateral area plus one base area, add it together to get my total surface area. And that is the total surface area of that pyramid. Hope this video was helpful.